watching your kid be sick and in the hospital and going through chemo. You can't even begin to imagine yourself in that position until you're there. When neurosurgery came in, they told us that he had a large mass. They said that it was about a quarter of his head size. And I feel like it was within minutes, oncology came in, Dr. Finlay came in, and he was like, it's absolutely cancer.
Nathan not only presented with this tumor in his head, this tumor had already spread throughout other parts of the brain and down the spinal cord. That's very difficult. And we're talking about a child who was an infant at that time.
Brain cancer is now the most common cause of death due to disease in kids. One of the challenges, it requires often radiation therapy, lots of different chemotherapy, and so there's a lot of side effects. Dr. Finlay is world renowned. People come from all around the world to seek out the advice and opinion and care by our brain tumor team, our neuro-oncology team.
It was kind of scary because we weren't really sure how his brain was going to react to having such a large mass removed. He tried to kind of prepare us, but I don't think you can really fully be prepared for something like that.
We decided to actually treat Nathan a little more like the current Head Start 4 study. What I tell the families, it's like giving a year's worth of therapy in 6 days, and then not give them radiation therapy.
Radiation therapy is sort of the most devastating sledgehammer. The side effects for a young and developing brain are very profound. The question is, can we substitute for it more intensive chemotherapy that doesn't damage the brain, but can still cure the tumor?
Having a doctor like Dr. Finlay that can do this whole protocol without using any radiation and still have a cure rate, for us, I mean, it was everything.
When you mention the word global, we are now in a pretty novel situation here at Nationwide Children's Hospital with our Institute of Genomic Medicine. We're going to do whole genome sequencing on the blood and the tumor of those children, address the question of who are the children with these tumors who are likely to do well with one type of therapy versus another. You hear the term personalized medicine, and this is an example of that. So my hope is that if our Nathan is going to get another tumor, we'll pick it up and we'll still be able to cure him.
I don't think we could have had a better oncologist for him. He knew from day one what it was and what treatment plan we were going to have to follow. For anyone, having their child sick in the hospital is scary, but ultimately through research and all the work that they're doing, we want to find a cure.